Question number eight. How do I find a co-founder or a partner? Wow. This is not an easy one. Well, the first thing is you have to know what you're looking for. You have to be clear on what you're trying to fill, the position you're fill. So is it a co-founder? Is it a, you know, 49-51 co-founder? What is that? Is it a CTO, which is, is it, you know, 20%? Like, you need to be clear on what you're looking for. And you need to be clear on the skills, you need to be clear on the culture, all those things you need to be clear on. Like, before you ever start to search for this person, just be really clear on what you're looking for. Once that is done, then you have to go out and meet a lot of people. There is no silver bullet for finding a great partner or co-founder. You have to, you know, kiss a lot of frogs, as they say. You have to go out to meetups. You have to go to, you know, events. You have to go, you know, talk to your friends, talk to your network, look people up on LinkedIn. You really just have to seek out these people, because they're, you know, the best ones are probably working, and the best ones are probably not looking for a job, right? Or they're not looking. But when you run into these people that are just, they're just the perfect fit, it's sometimes it is great. I mean, it's just great, and they come together, and pretty soon you've got a company, right? So it does happen. It happens all the time, but it is not easy, and it doesn't just happen overnight. You're not going to meet with five people and just pick one. That is absolutely the wrong thing to do. So be able to spend some time, be clear on what you're looking for. Don't hire the skills portion for the first thing. Hire the culture first. If this is your first employer, maybe it's your, you know, again, if it's a co-founder or partner, then, you know, you're building a culture together. Like, you're doing it together. So make sure you're clear on what that culture looks like. Talk about what happens if you disagree. Talk about things, how you handle conflict. Talk about, like, how you see the vision of a year from now or 18 months from now. You know, again, you really need to understand that. If you're interviewing someone that you've never worked with before, then you need to, you know, have a beer with them, go out to coffee, go to dinner, all these things, learn all these things about them, how they treat other people. Like, all those things are super important, because you honestly, in a startup, you're probably going to spend more time with your co-founder than you will with your partner. So be aware of that. Make sure they are a good fit culturally, not necessarily skill as the number one thing, right? Okay, so that's critical. Here's some mechanics on what to do once you do find. You don't want to give up equity first. You want to talk through equity. You want to get an understanding of what equity be, but you need to work with a person for at the minimum 30 days, but I would suggest say 60 or 90 days to understand if it's a good fit. And you need to be clear on that. Maybe you need to, maybe you pay them a little money for the first month and they don't get any equity, but you again, you're going into this and being transparent about it. It's like, hey, we don't want to, you know, give away equity until we know we're a good fit. So most people will be understanding of that. If they're not understanding of that, they may not be a good fit. So again, do not give away equity if you've not worked with that person ever. And even if you've worked with that person before, I would not give equity until you at least work together some on this new project that you're working on. So those are the things. Here's another thing that I found to be really helpful. Again, once you know what you're looking for, go talk to VCs, go talk to angel investors. Those people also know other people. Go talk to other founders. And when I say go talk to them, whether it's an email or whatever, but work the network of VCs, angels, and other founders. You know, those are the people that also know people as well. So that is a great network that you start working. And again, those are all about relationships. And if you're going to be raising money, you're going to be wanting to build those relationships with those VCs and angels. So those are the things you do to find that co-founder or partner. And again, I want to stress, it's not easy. There's no silver bullet. You have to go meet a lot of people and have a lot of 15-minute, 30-minute coffee meetings. But that's the only way you do it. And make sure you vet that person, you know, at every level possible. So that's it for question 8.